tagline for Vokel is letting the vineyard speak for itself. It's on the back of every one of the bottles. We try to focus on small growers, minimal intervention. So honestly, I don't want to say that the wine makes itself, but we try to kind of run that philosophy. We're not doing the challenges, we're not doing any, we're not giving the wine away. We're trying to let it kind of be organic and natural.
What was his name?
Marty.
Marty?
Martin's line for his name. Great guy. We've gone away too soon. He's only
gone out. Oh, gosh. I'm sorry to hear that.
Then we've got a bunch of different pinots. The Russian blend is a blend of three different vineyards that we made that year. And the other ones are all single vineyard pinots. Eastside Ranch is our state, where I live. Time per acre. It's a very, very concentrated wine. It's a really cool wine, and we're really lucky to have that vineyard site. It's neighboring some of the more impressive vineyards I've ever been to. It's unknown. It's a really surrounded by a really well known vineyard. If you guys have heard of Kistler, do you have that on the list here? Maybe not. Okay, it's not a different winery or a different restaurant. All right. Well, we're next door to Kistler and Marishi Vineyards, which is really, really high end vineyards. What else do we have here? H2A neighbors. H2A is a clone. I don't know if you guys know about clones. So, just like apples, how there's different types of apples. Granny Smith, Cool and Delicious. There's different clones for grapes. So, H2A is a specific type of Pinot Noir. It's typically known as being really light and more like a blending varietal, but this actually, the H2A is really nice standalone. It's the first wine that I submitted back in 2016 for points, and I got 93 on it, so it's pretty exciting. So, we're making H2A every year. The Heinz Vineyard, Charlie Heinz, has been farming for three generations. They have a 100-acre ranch that's a gorgeous ranch that on certain days you can smell the ocean. It's pretty far out there, pretty deep in the Snowy Hills. It's a really cool place. We make Chard and Pinot from there. The OG, I just love the name of that one. We're kind of battling with what we should call that one. It's the vines were planted in 1969, so most of the original Pinot Noir vines planted in our valley. Original gangster.
That's it. Love it.
Paris Chica, this guy is a pain in my ass. He's a owner in a cooling spa company, so they install pools, they manage hot tubs, service and everything. And then his hobby is that farm is about an acre. And I never know how much I'm gonna get from him every year because he's a novice farmer and he's not always the best. So one year he'll lose half the crop in mold. And so I'll get one ton. And then this past year I got 4.8 tons, which surprised the hell out of me. I had no idea I was expecting that much fruit. I thought I was gonna get about 2 tons from him. So he's really interesting. But his fruit's really cool. It's I joke that this wine, you can put it in with fresh tomatoes and you have pasta sauce. It's herbaceous. It's it smells bay leaves and Italian seasoning. It's dripping. So if you have a chance, you can try this. The Merlot, you guys have had on the list for a while. This is a Dry Creek Merlot, but it's on the southern side of Dry Creek. Dry Creek is a really long, narrow APA. The southern side is more towards us and Russian River, so it's cooler. So you get more fruit and less chalky high alcohol. It's also, this is the first vintage I made of Merlot in 2018. I'm really sad that we're sold out of it now. So what do you guys have for the last vintage? Then the two cabs, these are both super small vineyards. The McKelly vineyard is a half an acre, and I typically make 2 barrels off of it. The Luther is about an acre, I make 3 barrels off of it. Really concentrated, beautiful Napa fruits. The Vokel vines are there's first generation here in the U.S. He immigrated to Italy, India.